Greetings, I'm Mr. Spiffy, and welcome to the bottom of the barrel. I'm very, very tired, or at least I'm a little bit bleary. Last night, I didn't get in until 4:30 in the morning after driving from San Jose back home after getting to see Weird Al in concert, so I'm very glazed over. But this video needed to get done. I'm running a little late, I apologize on that. So, here to go over, the Battleground pay-per-view. And don't take my tiredness for boredness on this, because that's not the case. The Battleground pay-per-view was decent, and I just finished watching it, and I had to rewatch the main event because I dozed off during it. Not, again, not because it was boring, simply because exhaustion kind of caught up with me. So, let me kind of just give you a rundown of the show as a whole, and my thoughts on it. So the opening contest on the pre-show was the Usos versus Breezango. Better tag team match than I expected. Surprising outcome with Breezango picking up the win. I didn't do a prediction on this matchup because it hadn't yet been booked when I did the my predictions a few days back. I gave this match a C+. Decent quality matchup. Good outcome. I'm glad that they're going to give a solid push to other teams besides just the Usos. That's a good thing. Charlotte and Dana Brooke versus Sasha Banks and Bayley. Everything that they stated about this matchup seems to point that Bayley was doing a one-shot deal on the main roster, that she's not quite been pulled up yet, and they'll probably wait until after SummerSlam to make a permanent move for her. But we shall see. You know, that could all change tonight on Raw. That could change tomorrow on SmackDown. Who knows? Overall, very good matchup. Dana Brooke's interaction was minimal, and what she did didn't stink out the house, which is good. In the end, I gave the match a B-, and when Sasha Banks and Bayley picked up the victory. The New Day versus the Wyatt family. Everything you'd expect out of this matchup. Very high quality. At one point, at one point, Braun Strowman struck down Xavier Woods, and they referred to, Michael Cole went to say, swatted him like a fly, and instead said, flotted him like a swy. Okay, Cole, you're drunk, go home, or you're more tired than I am, so either way, go home, go back to bed. In the end, Xavier's fears caught up with him, and the Wyatt family was able to pick up the victory. Final score for that matchup was a B. Go into the U.S. title matchup, Rusev versus Zack Ryder. About what you'd expect. Decent back and forth. I think Ryder actually got some really close calls, but nothing major. In the end, Rusev picked up the win as Ryder almost broke the accolade and then didn't. I gave the match a C+. You have Rusev retaining the United States Championship. Backstage with Mick Foley, Stephanie, and Seth Rollins. Rollins talking about how great he is and how he's, you know, the best and the gift to them, and he's going to bring that title home, blah, 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 the usual stuff. And in the end, when Rollins walks by, Mick goes, "Don't look at me, you're the one who drafted him." We move on to the match of the night, Sami Zayn versus Kevin Owens. This match started off a little slow for me. In the end, they really picked it up. I don't know if the springboard moonsault mess-up was on purpose in order to try to bring in an arm injury, or if the rope itself was just too loose, because it looked to me like Sami hit it just the way he normally would, but it, instead of giving the spring, it just sort of like sank, which would be a sign that the top rope was loose. Either way, it was a bad-looking bump. Sami holding his arm throughout, but it looks like he did not sustain any real injury and was able to carry on and pick up the win in a major fashion with, like, two exploder-style suplexes and two haluba kicks to finally beat Kevin Owens. Very good matchup. I gave it a B+. Natalya versus Becky Lynch. About what you expect. I actually didn't expect to see Natalya win by submission, but she went out there and they did a good job. In the end, Natalya picks up the win. I gave it a C+. You have Shane Daniel Bryan pumping up Dean Ambrose. Ambrose said, that Daniel Bryan was his favorite to beat up in the Shield, and then wait, no, that wasn't right. It didn't come out the way he meant, but he just was his favorite opponent is what he kind of meant. Ambrose is ready to go for the title matchup. Intercontinental Championship, Darren Young versus The Miz. So you have Miz and Maurice come out referencing Eyes Wide Shut, which was an NC-17 movie originally. So definitely not a PG thing there, WWE. And you don't want your young audience trying to look up what that movie is. In the end, I don't know if Darren Young was disqualified or if The Miz was counted out. I couldn't tell exactly what happened. They had Darren Young snap like Bob Backlund used to do back in 1994, where he locked on what I think was originally supposed to be the Chicken Wing Crossface, but he actually locked him in a Cobra Clutch or Million Dollar Dream with the body scissors, which frankly I think works just as well. And in the end, he's sitting there staring at his hands like Bob Backlund. I'm interested to see where they're going to take that with Darren Young. Although, like I said, I wasn't certain of what the outcome was, so I couldn't even rate on whether or not I got this prediction right. But I did predict the fact that Miz walks out with the Intercontinental Championship, so that's about as close as I get. The match overall was just a C. It was bland. The ending was entertaining, and I'm looking forward to seeing where it goes. Cena, Enzo, and Cass versus The Club. Okay matchup. I gave it a C+. Some decent high-flying moments. Enzo, very entertaining before the matchup with his speeches. Enzo is a mixed bag for me. Sometimes he makes me laugh, other times he doesn't. This time, he got me. So, there you go. I gave the match a C+. In the end, John Cena with a Super AA picks up the win over AJ Styles, leaving room for them to continue to feud. They each have a 1-to-1 pinfall ratio over the other. And we then move on to the highlight reel with Randy Orton. Surprisingly more entertaining than I gave it credit for, because frankly I was not expecting much. Randy Orton typically bores the shit out of me. Orton actually had some entertaining moments, made reference to Brock Lesnar's enhancement issues with UFC, and in the end, of course, hits an RKO on Chris Jericho, who was pretty much just begging for it the entirety of the conversation. Okay segment to lead into the WWE Championship. We have both general managers and both commissioners at ringside as the WWE Championship, Seth Rollins versus Roman Reigns versus Dean Ambrose. For this being the culmination of the Shield fighting each other, it could have been better. And I blame a lot of this on Roman Reigns. And it was the fact that had Roman Reigns not fucked up royally, they probably would have had a different outcome, for starters. Secondly, I think that Roman Reigns would have probably kicked out of Dirty Deeds. There would have been more false finishes going into this matchup instead of, in the end, Roman hits the spear and then Dean Ambrose hits Dirty Deeds and picks up the victory. Overall, the dynamic was good. I don't think they dropped the ball. They just were told, well, you don't get to do quite as special of a match as we originally intended. Why? Because Roman fucked up. In the end, Roman Reigns was the one who took the pinfall, which is what you'd expect from the guy who just came off a suspension. He took the pinfall and got beat. The WWE Championship now going to SmackDown. There's talk that right now the WWE Champion will be floating between the two shows. There's still no word on what's going on with the Tag Team Championship. There's still no word of what's going on with the Women's Championship in that manner. In the end, I gave the WWE Championship match a B-. I think they went out there and did a decent job with what they had. And certainly, you know, this was all about Roman and Ambrose, Rollins and Ambrose, much like I had said in my prediction video. Final score for WWE Battleground was a B-, bordering on a C+. It had its really good moments. And the moments that shined well. I think it was a little interesting when they kept showing the dynamic of like the Raw locker room and the SmackDown locker room. Especially when you've got, on the Raw locker room, Braun Strowman leaning on a wall back there. And then you have, in the SmackDown locker room, you have Eric Rowan with his sheet mask on. Sitting there back there, I don't know if he's peeling stuff off himself and throwing it on the floor. But he's just kind of there. The one person who I noticed was missing out of that dynamic was Bray Wyatt. Bray Wyatt wasn't in the SmackDown locker room. Also, I saw Simon Gotch get into the ring during the Aftermath celebration with Ambrose, but I didn't see him backstage in the locker. room. So I don't know what they did with that one. But in the end, you know, SmackDown came out and celebrated with Dean Ambrose and showing brand solidarity. So you get that out of it. Tell me what your thoughts are on Battleground. Again, I apologize for the lateness of this video, but I have a life and I've been out and about. No review for Raw. I don't even know if I'm going to watch Raw tonight. I'll probably wind up watching it tomorrow and then watching SmackDown the day after. I'll just be a little bit behind in the times because tonight, in about 3 hours, I'm going to go see... It was, you know, well, no, not that Batman. I'm going to go see The Killing Joke. I'm shown in a one-time deal over at the local movie theater, so I'm looking forward to getting to see that. It's probably one of the darkest comics ever written. I heard mixed reviews coming out of San Diego Comic-Con, so we'll have to see if it lives up to it. Either way, I'm going to enjoy what's sure to be probably the darkest animated piece that's ever come out of the DC Universe, and we'll see how that goes. As always, please like, share, subscribe, and comment. And I'm Mr. Spiffy, and this barrel's been scraped clean. I'll be back on Wednesday with the next Royal Road, which should be the Royal Rumble 1991. See you there.